Okay, good morning and welcome today back to the class. On Friday, we had given you a few definitions and a few things to write regarding the frequency distribution. Today, I would be doing a few numericals based on what we have done. And for that, I have questions which I am going to share with you on the screen. Okay, so please tell me when you get it on the screen. One of you, any one of you, you will please tell me. Okay. Is it visible, Krish Gupta? Yes, thank you. Now, question number one. Kindly look at it. Kindly look at question number one. Construct a discrete series with the help of the data given on marks obtained by 10 students in a class. Kindly copy this down in your copy. All these which I'm going to do on board as well. The questions are there for you. Question number one. Now, we have to construct a discrete series with the help of a data given of 10 students. First of all, we will place these data in an ascending order under the heading marks. What is the smallest value there? 10, 14, 16, 17, then 18 and 20. Second, we have tally bars. And third, we have total, which is the frequency. Now, please count how many tens are there. 1, 2. So you have two tally bars and place the value here. 14. How many values are there for 14? 1, 2, and 3. So there are three tally bars. Value here, 3. 16. How many there for 16? Just 1. 17. Again, 1. 18. 2. So 2 tally bars. And 20. How many are there? Just 1. So here we have total 2, 3, 4, 7, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Total of 10. This is your first answer. Second question. Construct a continuous series with the help of the data given below. Kindly note down the question. Please copy down the question. Construct a continuous series with the help of the data given below. The data is 36, 22, I'm reading it out. 36, 22, 44, 43, 21, 32, 33, 34, 23, 24, 25, 26, 28, 40 and 42. These are the data given. We have to construct a continuous series. First and foremost, children, from the data given, identify the smallest and the largest number. Now, the smallest number over here, I can identify as 23. Okay. And the largest I can identify as 44. Now, when we make class intervals, always remember class intervals are made in groups of fives or multiples of five. Since the smallest value is 23, we can safely have a class interval, let's say from 20 to 25, keeping class intervals in fives. So here we have class interval. Twenty to twenty-five, twenty-five to thirty, thirty to thirty-five, thirty-five to forty, forty to forty-five. The second column you'll have tally bars. Tally bars. And the third you'll have frequency or F. Frequency, you can simply also write F. Now, this is nothing new you are doing just now. You have already done these in the class 10. Whenever there is occurring, you put a tally bar. When you have a 5, you will put a cross or you put a bar over it. You've been taught that in 10 class, isn't it? So the same thing follows over here. Now, from this, you will now plot the values. The first one, 36. 36 will come here. Next value is 22 will come here. Next value is 44 will come here. Then next value is 43 here. Then 21 over here. Next value is 32. 32 comes here. Then 33 and 34. 33 and 34 comes here. Then 23, 24, 25. 23, 24, 25 will not come here, but since this is the exclusive method, 25 will come in the next occurrence, not over here. Okay. Then 26 and 28, 26 and 28 and 40, 42. 40 again will not come here. 40 will come here and 42 will come over here. Okay. So now total them up. 4, 3, 3, 1, 4. This will be total 5, 8, 11 and 4, 15. How many values do we have? 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 15 values. So we know we have plotted and is that okay, children? How did we form the class interval? First of all, by spotting the smallest and then the largest. And when we are forming class intervals, we normally form them in fives or multiples of five. Whenever there is an upper value to be included, like 25. Now, 25 will not be included in this class interval of 20 to 25. But 25 will be included in the next class of 25 to 30. Similarly, 30 will not be included here. It will be included in the next class. This is the exclusive method. Okay. Can I wipe out the board? Give me a thumbs up if it is okay. Okay. Third question. Convert the following series into a less than and a more than cumulative frequency or series. Now, when we are converting a series into a less than and a more than, and we have them in the class intervals, when we are converting the less, we will take the upper limit of the class, and when we are converting the more, we will take the lower limit of the class. So first of all, we'll write less than cumulative frequency, less than cumulative frequency okay. What do we see? Classes of 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50. Here when we are taking the less than, we will always take the upper limit. So less than 10, less than 10, less than 20, less than 30, less than 40, till where do we go on? 50, less than 50. Okay, this is the first thing. Then the second thing is, in a less than series, the frequencies which are given are cumulated. In other words, they are added. So the first one is 5. 5 plus 10, 15. That is 5 plus 10. Then 15 plus 15, 30. That is 5 plus 10 plus 15. Then 30 plus 12 is 42. 42 is the sum of 5 plus 10 plus 15 plus 12. And 42 plus 8 is 50. That is, it is the sum of 5, 10 plus 15 plus 12 plus 8. And we can call this as X, we can call this as the frequency F. So pay attention, when we are converting a series into a less than and more than, if you look at the question, less than, we will take the upper limit, less than 10, less than 20, less than 30, less than 40, less than 50. And the frequencies which are given, they are cumulated. Cumulated means they are added. Okay. Now, more than. When we are doing the more than series, we will take more than and then the lower limit. Okay. So here we have more than cumulative series. So here we have more than 0, more than 10, more than 20, more than 30, more than 40. This is the X series frequencies. Now, in this, what do we do? The maximum which is over here will be for more than zero. More than zero is 50. Then 50 minus 5, 45. 50 minus 15 is 35. Okay, then 15 minus 42 will be how much? So 50, 45, 35, keep on minusing 20, 50 minus 30, 20, and 50 minus 42, 8. This is how you convert the more than series. From what we have, since the maximum is 50, everyone who is more than zero will be maximum. And from this figure, you minus the figure on top. So 50 minus 5, 50 minus 15, 50 minus 30, 15 minus 42. That's how you would get your more than series. Have you understood, all of you children? Fourth question. Please copy the fourth question. Please copy the fourth question. Prepare frequency table of ages of 25 students of 11th class in your school. And the data is given of 25 students. Copy the data properly. Meanwhile, I'll rub out the board. Okay. So what do we have here? We have age. We have tally bars. And we have the frequency. Now, from the data given to you, spot out the lowest and the highest number. I spot 15, then there's 16, there's 17, there's 18, and then there is 19. That's the values. So I have ages of 15, 16, 17, 18, and 19. Now let us start from the first value and keep placing tally bars, or you can even count them all and put them over there. Count how many 15s are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So you will place them as 1, 2, 3, 4. 5 will be crossed. 6, 7. Frequency 7. 16. How many 16s are there? Count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 are there. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 calibers. 17. 17 is how many? Count 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. How many are there of 18? 1, 2, 3. 18 is 3. 1, 2, and 3. 19. How many there in 19? Just 1. 4 and 5, 9 and 9, 18, 25. How many students' age was given? 25. So your total should match the data given. Please take down. You don't need to take down the next question because the next question is in your book on page 38, question number 6. Children, the next question is in your textbook, page 38, question number 6. The only difference over here and in the book, here it is the number of domestic appliances and over there it is the number of cell phones. The data is absolutely the same. So you can mark it in the book, question number 6 of your book on page number 38. Okay. So now we are in question number 5, doing question number 5. Can I wipe out this board? Yes. Tanish, thumbs up. Okay. In a city of 45 families were surveyed for the number of domestic appliances they used. Prepare a frequency array based on the replies as recorded below. So here we will write, first of all, number of, in your book it is written there cell phones, so I am writing cell phones. What is the smallest value given there? 0 is the smallest. And what is the maximum value given there? 7 is the maximum. So here we'll have number of cell phones from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Then we have the tally bars. And then we have the frequency. Okay. Now let's place the tally bars from the data we have. Check out how many zeros are there. Just one. So one tally bar, one frequency. check out how many ones are there. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 seven ones are there. So how do we place them? 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. How many twos are there? Count. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 13 14 15. How many are there? 15. So 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 13 14 15, and we write here 15. 3. Let us count how many 3s are there. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12. 12 threes. So 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12. Threes are 12. Fours, let us count fours. Nothing in this line. 1 2 3 4 fours. 4, one more. 5. 5. 1 2 3 4 5. 5. 1 2 3 4 and 5. 5 fours. Then fives, how many fives are there? Just in this line, 1 and 1, 2. So 2 are there for 5. How many sixes are there? 6, 1, 2. That's it. 6 is 2. 7, how many are there for 7? Just 1. Total 3 into 5 10 22 27 37 38 39 40 45. Total 45. How many data was given to us? 45 families. So we are correct. So children, we have done 5 questions on frequency distribution. It is a simple method, nothing new. You have done it already in the 10th class, I believe. Also, you have done it in the 10th class, tally bars and frequencies. Yes. So anyway, it is in your portion, so we have to do it. We will continue the rest of the questions tomorrow, and all these questions should be in your class, one copy which you have made for statistics, please. Okay, all the notes, all the question and answers, all the numericals will be in your statistics note copy, notebook. Is that okay? Anyone has any problem? Anyone wants to ask anything? Anyone? If no, then we will stop till here and continue tomorrow with some more numericals. And also we will do the question and answers of the chapter. Till then, all of you have a nice day and stay safe.